Hello, folks, and welcome back to Austria. Welcome back to the Red Bull Ring. Will Buxton and Lawrence Barreto actually bringing you some breaking news. It has just been announced a few moments ago that Fernando Alonso will return to Formula One in 2021 for a third period with the Renault F1 team. Surprised me. Did it surprise you?
Definitely. I don't think anyone was expecting more big news between Austria 1 and Austria 2. But it's the news that I think will get a lot of people excited. It's Fernando Alonso, a double world champion, left Formula One when people weren't really expecting him to, didn't feel like he had unfinished business. And here he is again, coming back for more, hoping to kind of right the wrongs, I think, of the way that he left Formula One. It didn't quite go the way that he planned.
Yeah, absolutely. Now look, the driver market has been very fluid. It's moved incredibly quickly this year throughout the pandemic. Obviously, Carlos going to Ferrari, Daniel moving to McLaren. We weren't really expecting any more big moves this early. How has the deal come about and what does the deal look like?
So for Renault, they really wanted to find someone soon just to kind of keep everyone at the back of the factory motivated. It must have really hurt them all the way down to the factory floor when Daniel left, because it was almost like he didn't believe in the project. Now, he said that isn't the case. You know, he just wanted a new opportunity and he's getting that at McLaren. But Renault really needed to do something and do something quick. And they've gone and got a double world champion who's won with them before, who hopefully the staff will believe can take them forward, because we've talked about Renault a lot in recent years. They haven't really made that step forward. So throughout the last few weeks and a couple of months actually, Fernando and Cyril and the Renault board have been discussing whether he can come back to Formula One. And they've given it a lot of thought, Fernando's given it a lot of thought, and they've decided that this is what they want to do. They want to work together and try and bring Renault back to the front of the field.
Fascinating. Do we know how long it's for?
So it's definitely for more than 1 year. Often they describe it as multi-year. Yes. I think you're looking at sort of a two-year deal and then they'll both see where they are after that. And I think that works for both parties. Renault get Fernando's commitment. Fernando gets a couple of years to really understand what he wants to do with the project.
Of course, we've spoken about the driver market. It does put things into play, of course. A number of drivers being spoken about as regarded that Renault seat. One of them was Mercedes Valtteri Bottas. You know, if the musical chairs had all worked out and that dream pairing of Vettel and Hamilton had happened, then there was a chance Valtteri might have needed to find somewhere else. Talk that his management was talking to Cyril over the break. But all of that revolved around Sebastian getting the nod at Mercedes, and Toto confirmed to us on Friday that wasn't going to happen. Valtteri looks pretty safe at Mercedes. Seb, that's a big question mark. We look at Joe. Great kid, great future ahead of him. Needed a third place in F2 this year to be assured the super license points to get to F1, but he'll be put on the back burner, I would imagine, for the next couple of seasons. All of this, though, Fernando coming back, puts a big question mark over Sebastian Vettel. What on earth happens to the four-time world champion now? Because the doors are closing.
I don't think he would have been that pleased when he saw this news come out, because while he hadn't really had proper talks with Renault, I think he would have felt that that was an opportunity for him. And now that door has slammed shut. And like you just hinted at, Will, there's not a lot of opportunities left on the grid. There are seats available, but realistically, where Sebastian can slot right in at his point in his career, it's not looking that great.
There was some talk that Fernando had been talking to Aston Martin, Racing Point, as we know them at the moment. So if Fernando was talking to them, and we'd always thought that those two seats were out of bounds because it's difficult to get rid of Checo. He brings a lot of money, even for a mark like Aston Martin. Checo brings a lot of money to play. Lawrence Stroll, is he going to drop his lad Lance? You know, those look like two pretty solid seats. And yet, if Fernando was talking to them, might that be the only place left open for him? Fascinating to see how this Fernando news will play out in the driver market. Let's look at the Fernando news, though, in more detail. Is this face-saving for Renault? They've been saying for years that they were rebuilding. They'd promised Daniel they'd done all that rebuilding work. He was coming in for a team that was ready to fight for podiums, race wins, championships. And within 12 months, he's decided that they're not ready to do that, and he's off to somewhere which is McLaren. It's an embarrassing move for Cyril, who put so much into that for Daniel and Renault future. Is this just face-saving for Cyril and for Renault that they lost their big headline driver?
I think this is just a great thing for both of them. It's a marriage made in heaven, because you've got Renault and Cyril, who really needed to pull someone big in, and they've got a double world champion. So he's done his job there. But I think for Fernando, he's been at home. He's had these projects, the Indy 500 project, Le Mans, Dakar, and he's enjoyed it and he's loved it, but it's not a full-time racing contract, and he's got a lot of time at home, and he's probably getting bored. That's what people who I know who know him have said, that he just needs that challenge. And we know what Fernando was like when he left. He was still competitive. He had that burning desire inside of him, and I think that still burns, and if not, burns more brightly now that he, you know, 2 years away from Formula One. So I think together, at this time, at this moment in time, they've come together at the right time. Fernando needs Renault, and Renault most definitely need Fernando.
It's also positive from the perspective of Renault itself. There have been so many rumours, would they stay, wouldn't they stay? Of course, new top line management at Renault itself, and bringing in Fernando, who won't be cheap, surely reaffirms their commitment to the sport.
I think Renault really needed to bring in a star driver after they had Daniel, so they would have had to put money on the table to do that, and that's what they had to do with Fernando Alonso. You know, he's a star name, they're going to need to pay him well. But I think for them and the board, they just need to prove that they're a race-winning team or contending for race wins or on the way there. And we haven't really seen that enough. They kind of had that upward trajectory, then they plateaued, and they really need to start making steps quickly. And I think Fernando, what they're hoping, is their saviour. And he'll come in and he'll give them that extra bit. You know, when the driver gets the most out of the car, he'll just get a little bit more. And I think that's what they're hoping for with Fernando.
Big money contracts for Daniel Ricciardo, big money contracts for Fernando Alonso. Would that money have been better spent on the car?
I mean, it's a good question. The thing is, Renault is so well-resourced that you'd hope that they, if they spend their resources wisely, the budget that they're working with should be enough to at least start making progress. You could always argue that you can save money on a driver and put it into the car, but they're probably hoping that that extra thing that you get from Fernando, that extra speed that only Fernando can give you, or at least he showed many times, is going to be worth every penny that they're spending on him.
The other question, and I'm sorry, it sounds like I keep coming up with the negative potentials with all of this, but of course it wasn't a happy hunting ground for him with McLaren. And a very similar situation, a team that was rebuilding, a team that had tasted championship success, one of the most successful teams in the sport's history, but trying to get back to the front again. He got frustrated. Mm-hmm. It was supposed to be a long-term project. He didn't see it out. A lot of infighting, a lot of acrimony in the way that that all fell apart. Does he still have the patience? Because he's not a spring chicken, he's not a young guy anymore. He is in the latter years of his career. He wants to be fighting for race victories. Does he have the patience to see through a rebuilding project and see podiums and championships further down the line than maybe 1 or 2 years?
There's no doubt, Will, that it's a risk. It's a massive risk signing Fernando for those very reasons. He, at any point, when the car doesn't go well, he could really struggle, and then he could then start complaining and moaning and putting the pressure on the team. They're going to know that when they signed up, but they're hoping that what they get from him is worth it. What I would say is that Fernando's been away for 2 years now, so I think that the desire to be back might kind of temper that early on, and hopefully if he can get some results under his belt, that might help. But it's definitely going to be challenging, and all the people in Instone are going to be wary of Fernando blowing up, shall we say, because it happens so often.
Yes, and they know how to deal with him if he does. I think overall, it's just fantastic, you know, to see Fernando Alonso back. As we were saying, we may lose a four-time champion in Sebastian, but if we get back this two-time champion in Fernando, what a driver to have back on the grid. And there will be headlines no matter what happens between him and Renault.
He's a fantastic character, we were saying earlier. Just look at the poses, you know, that he used to display after he won. If Fernando's around, people are talking about him, and not only what he does on track, but when he's off track as well. And I think it's a great thing for Formula One. I'm super excited to see him back, although I do think it's going to be challenging.
There we go. The driver market then has taken an unexpected turn. Fernando Alonso will be back in Formula One with Renault in 2021. From Lawrence, from myself, we'll see you later.